Doctor, we'll go into the next question.
Hi ma'am, I'm Ramya. I'm doing my B.Tech. I'm final year student, but I'm 22 years old now. Mm-hmm. So today, youth is very much concerned about their health on skin, hair and all. Yeah. So I would like to know about various treatments for dandruff. Is there any relation with our daily food habits? That is, we must include more fiber content food. What all are the precautions we must take to prevent dandruff?
I think this is one of the commonest problems that almost everybody is facing.
Dandruff, it's very common. Dandruff actually involves two processes. One is there will be an increased production of the cells. There's an increased rate of production of the cells of the scalp for some reason. That's because of an inherent nature of the person. Okay. And secondly, on top of this, there is an overgrowth of a fungus called Pterosporum ovale. Okay. And it's the combination of these two mechanisms that causes the flaking and the itching associated with dandruff. But another thing is that dandruff may not, it's usually due to something called seborrheic dermatitis. Mm-hmm. But other skin conditions can also cause dandruff, like atopic dermatitis or psoriasis. Mm-hmm. These are all things that cause a similar clinical picture to seborrheic dermatitis. Seborrheic dermatitis is the most common cause. Okay. So the first thing you should go and see a doctor to determine what the cause of your dandruff is. Mm-hmm. And if it is seborrheic dermatitis, like I said, you should use something, a medicine that addresses both of the problems. That is the increased production of the cells as well as the fungus.
Okay.
So ideally you should use a shampoo which contains coal tar. Coal tar is a medicine which controls the increased over proliferation of the skin cells.
Okay.
And or salicylic acid. This also controls the overproduction of the skin cells. And along with that, the shampoo must also include an antifungal, which may be ketoconazole, selenium sulfide, zinc pyrithione, cyclopyrox. These are all antifungals. Another thing is that usually what patients say is that doctor, yani shampoo ubechu oru maasam ubechittum dandruff poyilla. That will never happen. Dandruff can only be controlled. It cannot be totally eradicated. Okay. There is no cure for dandruff. Just like a person needs to continue medicines for diabetes or hypertension, the shampoo for dandruff should be used at least twice a week continuously, because you can only keep it under control.
Okay.
That's a common mistake that youngsters make when taking treatment for dandruff.
Doctor, we have a male. I'm a 19-year-old engineering student. When I go to college, I usually don't get enough time to change my napkins, so that it causes itching at my genital area. So what should I do?
That's a very common problem.
Okay.
Because use of sanitary pads, especially the ones nowadays, the ones with wings. These cause when used for prolonged periods from morning to evening, and along with that, along with the humidity, especially in our climate, the increased humidity and the heat, it leads to a secondary fungal infection of the area. So the best thing for this is prevention. Always prevention is better than cure. So find time to change your sanitary napkin in between. At least it should be changed at least 2 to 3 times per day, depending, and even more depending on your flow. So that's the best thing. That's the only thing you can do for this. Change your napkin, and if possible, avoid using the types with wings.
Wings, okay.
That's the best
thing. So personal hygiene is the best remedy for this.
It's the best remedy.
Okay. So doctor, this was really an informative talk. Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam.
If you have any suggestions or doubts, please write to us. Our email ID is youthdiaryroseball@gmail.com. See you next week. Till then, it's me, Nita Ghosh, signing off.